Welcome to ASET Online. I'm Dr. Asha Vishwanath, Department of Civil Engineering. Now we come to the part 3 of the module Dynamics of EST100 for the first years. Now in this part, we will be looking at curvilinear motion. Now rectilinear motion, the kinetics and kinematics, we say that it is motion in a straight line. Now curvilinear motion is when the path traversed by the object is a curved line, we call it curvilinear motion. Now, when there is a curved motion, the velocity acts tangentially at any point on the curve. Now, as you can see, there is an angular motion which passes through an angle theta with a radius of r, and the velocity with which it moves through the angle theta is denoted by omega, which is the angular velocity. Now the linear velocity is related to the angular velocity, and you can see the velocity acting at any point on the curve is tangential. Now the different relations between all the components, that is the displacement, velocity, acceleration, are connected just in the case of rectilinear motion, and you can see how the analogous equations are written out. Theta is the displacement, which is angular velocity omega, initial angular velocity omega 0, alpha is the angular acceleration, and the relations are just as we have with them in the rectilinear motion. Now the relation between the rectilinear and the curvilinear quantities are as follows. Rs is equal to r theta, where it is connected using the radius of the motion. Now velocity is r omega and acceleration is r alpha. Now the angular velocity may either be in radians per second, or it can be given in revolutions per minute. Now the conversion of revolutions per minute into radians per second is as shown. For n revolutions per minute, you convert it as 2 pi n by 60 rad per second. Now with this curvilinear motion, we will look at certain problems. In nature, we find that curved motions usually occur when there are a car moving along a curve, or a pendulum. The movement of a pendulum is curved. A motion of a projectile are some of the examples of curvilinear motion. Now two differences in these types of motion is, in a projectile motion, we find there is both a horizontal and vertical motion. So you find that there is a initial velocity, a stone thrown with the initial velocity undergoes both a vertical motion as well as a horizontal motion, while a car passing through a curve, or a cyclist passing through a curve, undergoes just the horizontal motion. So there are two types of problems we will be dealing with in this curvilinear translation, that is both the horizontal alone and the horizontal and vertical together.